in the previous video that we will do the notice writing of this chapter. So just have a look at the board. Here, please don't look that side because that is a squirrel which we will be just now studying just after doing this notice writing. So, okay. So this is notice writing. Now what is notice writing? Notice writing is done generally when we want to convey a message to a good number of people. Like generally in the schools, we do write about some competitions. We do inform them about something lost and found things. If such and such thing has been lost at this place and it was like this, if you happen to find, please contact so and so. Or if we find something, such thing has been found on this place, it is like this, of this color, of this size. So if it belongs to someone, please come and collect from this person. Okay, so notice is generally written when we want to convey a message to a good number of people. It is not only used in schools, it is used in maximum offices and organizations. If they want to inform about anything, they can use this notice. So nowadays, notice writing is important because we should know how to convey the message in what format, in the correct words. Okay, so first and foremost thing for the notice writing is, whenever you happen to get a question of notice writing, don't forget to make this box. This box has to be compulsorily made. First, second thing, always put the heading of notice on the top middle side in block and in a good size so that it is visible from far also. Yes, there is some notice on the board. Then write the date on your top left corner. Just below notice, you need to write the topic. Okay? On what topic you are writing. It can be lost, it can be found, or it can be competition, or it can be election, or it can be a meeting. It can be anything. Got it? Now, start with the next line. From the left-hand corner, left-hand side, with your content. See, notice writing doesn't have any salutation, means dear sir, respected sir, no need of all these formalities. In notice writing, we directly come to the topic, jo baat kehne, come to the point, okay? So, without any dear, respected and this and that, we come to the point that a yellow leather purse with a single key in it has been lost. If anyone finds it, please contact Shreshta Gupta, class 7C. Okay, so here Shreshta is informing about her lost purse. She has informed the color of the purse and the material of which it is made. It is yellow leather purse and there is a single key in it and nothing else. Okay. Same way we can write a notice about anything. We can write about found. Right now, so I can write here. A blue woolen scarf has been found in the dance room. Whoever is the right owner can come and contact or can come to me in such room and I can write my name. Got it? So here there's a question. Then after that a suitable reward will be given to the person and then in the end the person who is writing has to sign and then write the name. Okay? So this is the format of the notice. You have to follow it and there is a question below which you have to do it as a homework. So here is, using the same format, lawn tennis court. Remember to give a brief description of the jacket. Okay, because you have lost it, you should describe how it looked, what color it is, or what was the size of the jacket, and then move to contact. Not necessary to give the reward. Okay, so this will be your homework. Now let us come to the next chapter, that is section C. Okay, children, and that section C. So children, our chapter is Tippity, the flying squirrel. Tippity, the name of the squirrel about whom we are going to study in the chapter. Okay, so let us have a look and read the intro. Squirrels belong to the rodent family. Now, who are rodents? Rodents are small, four-footed animals like rats. Okay? With strong, sharp front teeth. Okay? Which they use for gnawing and nibbling. They do it with this. So they are rodents like rats. So squirrel also belong to the same family. Now, rearrange these groups of letters to find the names of some rodents. Now I am not going to tell you, though the first one I have already told you, but the remaining you will do yourself and let me know with your notice writing. So let us start with the chapter Tippity the Fly Squirrel. So yes, there are squirrels which can fly, and these squirrels are very cute also. So let's start. To know Tippity was to love her. So if you want to know, you have to love her. And I have known her for very long. From a long time, and I love her. Okay? Tippity, I must tell you, was not a naughty little girl with penchant for climbing up curtain poles. Penchant? Fond of? Mazata of? Particular? So, naughty. So, Tippity is not a naughty girl who likes to climb on the curtain. Curtain poles, those curtain rods. But it is a little rodent commonly called a flying squirrel. The large red flying squirrel. It is really large. Red colored. It is not that exactly red like an apple. But yes, you can say like that of a apricot. Slightly darker than that. So, and squirrel and must on no account be mistaken for the flying fox. So, it is totally different from the flying fox, because flying fox are different and flying squirrels are totally different, which has nothing to do with the Tippity's family, because flying fox is totally a different family. And Tippity, the flying squirrel, is a different family. And children, this unit is totally dependent on, totally based on nature, right? So, in section A, we studied about daffodils. In section B, we studied about the rain in Rani Khet's gift. And in section C, we are studying about the squirrel, right? So, let us continue. So, from where this author has got this squirrel? A strange squirrel. It is not a normal squirrel which is there on the trees, in our gardens, in our farms. This squirrel is totally different. It is a flying squirrel. A squirrel which can fly. And it is larger than a normal squirrel that we find in our farms and in our gardens. Got it? Not only this, the color of the squirrel is also reddish. She was brought to me when only a few days old. the bulb. And 2 feet of bushy tail. 2 feet of her bushy tail. Now you can very well imagine the size of the squirrel. She knew she was fascinating. Fascinating, attractive, beautiful. It can attract people towards her. So that squirrel knew that I'm beautiful. Okay? And she knew that she is attractive. She is beautiful. She is fascinating. And she knew that she is fascinating even at a very early age. What question was it? That I look beautiful and people like me. I look good. And nothing delighted her more than to show off her lovely tail. उसको सबसे ज्यादा मजा आता था अपनी tail को show off करने में. It was a long tail, है ना? If we have long hair, how we will show off, right? Same way, the squirrel, she knew that she looks beautiful. People are attracted towards her, and she likes to show off her tail. Style बारे में मजा आता था tail के साथ, okay? Her one drawback, कमी, negative side of the squirrel was as a pet, because the squirrel is a pet of the author, was that she was nocturnal. Now what are nocturnal? Nocturnal creatures are the key creatures which are active at night. I repeat, nocturnal are the creatures which are active at night when people, human beings, sleep. Okay, so she was nocturnal and so was most lively when it was time for ordinary people to be in bed. So throughout the day she was not so active. We are not saying that she's too lazy, but she's not that active. She sleeps, but at night, full of energy. Have you seen small babies? They sleep throughout the day and they are active at night. And gradually they come to the normal cycle as other people. But when they are just born, these newborn babies, they sleep throughout the day. And when everybody is in a mood to sleep, they get awake and they are full of their activities and lively and very happy and they want to play. Right now, same thing is with this squirrel. This flying squirrel, Tippity is the name of that pet, is a nocturnal creature and she likes to show off because she knows that she is beautiful and she is very active at night when human beings are asleep. Got it? Want to have a look at the Tippity? Let's have a look at Tippity. So children, just have a look. This is the flying squirrel and it belongs to the rodent family. And it has a long tail, though the picture doesn't show the long tail much clearly. But this flying squirrel is the squirrel about which we are talking in the chapter. So we will continue with the chapter in the next video. Till then, I want you to read the chapter, do your notice, and to solve those 4 words. Okay? Till then, thank you, children.